Hello guys, this is Cat's Diary. Welcome back. Today I want to talk to you about how cats are actually smart or not. I remember my grandma, she used to say, "Oh, he's looking at me so smartly with his eyes. The only thing he cannot do is he can't speak." Let's say that. But on the other hand, you probably remember that old saying that cats have 9 lives. If that is true, well, then they really have to be smart. Well, let's not take these sayings, stupid sayings, on for our basis, but let's take some solid ground and let's see what science have to say. Anatomically speaking, cats' brains are smaller than a dog's brain or human as well. But since size is not the only thing that matters here, let's take a little deeper look. Now, did you know that human brains are only 10% different than a cat's brain? Further, let's take a look at the number of neurons. Now, cats have their incerebral cortex of the brain about 300 million neurons, while dogs have only 160 million. Now, we can easily say that cats are smarter than dogs, but human, we have over 21 billion of neurons, and that is quite a lot. But how does that help us if we still need to follow Kim Kardashian on Instagram or watching every single football game on the planet just to have fun? So the scientists have found out that the intelligence of a grown cat is about the same that intelligence of a 2-year-old child. Birman cats are known as a middle intelligent cats, but I do not think we should judge cats just by their breed. After all, developing intelligence of each cat is a process, and that process also includes the environments they live, the experience they get, and the character of each cat. Now, I've been living with the Birman cats now for 3rd generation, and I can tell you that Ori, as much as I remember her, was basically a super smart, and there was no problems with her after all. Now, the others are pretty much on the same level, so they make difference about how they put out their needs and their wishes, but if I compare them to any domestic cat, the level is pretty much the same. So let's not make any judgment here, but let's say that they are pretty much at the same level. Intelligence of the cat can be defined as the ability to learn from their experience and then put that experience and that knowledge they got from the experience into a real life and new environment. Well, yes, the cats don't need to save some equals or to learn Shakespeare or something like that, but they need to learn how to survive in certain environment. Now, in surviving in nature, it's quite different than the cats that are living indoor with us, because they have plenty of time, usually they have food, everything is cleaned up, so these are the things they don't need to think about how they will solve them. So the cat's life in some certain community who are living indoors is basically how to survive the time they have left. And in real life, that means like, how to screw my owner. For example, you know that cats are very much attached to their daily routine, and they develop that in the first few years of their life. I remember my old Nika. She was used to sleep with me, and then in the middle of the night, she got up and she went to eat and she went for a toilet. And if it happened accidentally that the doors were closed, she started meowing and scratching and making all different noises, so she woke me up, and then I got up, opened the doors for her, and she could go to do the things she was used to do then every night. Now, I'm afraid I don't have any footage to show you that, but I'm sure you can picture how that happened every night. Animals are pretty much driven by their instinct. In reality or in the nature, that means how to get enough food to survive the day and how to be safe. So food is a good motivator. I remember I had a dog once. It was Golden Retriever. Her name was Scala, and she was absolutely crazy about food. And she even liked to go to the veterinary's office because she knew she will have some food there. But with the cats, the story is slightly different. So food is not the only thing that motivates them, or even other, some are not even be able to motivate it with the food. So if you want your cat to do something, something funny, something interesting, you need to find what they like, what motivates them. Now, if you want your cat to be playful and so you will keep her in good shape, you need to do something that he likes. Let's take Jinx. He has enough to eat, and yes, of course, I want him to stay playful and fit, so I need to find a lot of ways to give their time more meaningful. And sometimes he likes to play with his mouth or with the toilet paper. Nevertheless, cats that are living indoors are also driven by their hunting instinct, and some of them are so hungry for blood when they see a bird or a mouse because they have that written in their genes. It is interesting that some cats lose this instinct through the years, but another one, they still have it even when they are 15 years old. Thank you for watching us. That was all for today. If you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss more stories from Cat's Diary. Bye bye.